you guys sure seem to know how to respond to adversity.
Yeah, that's a good plug. Character in that locker room, a lot of trust. The chemistry too is high. I think your leader is always ready to play. It's easy to follow. Bounce back game from playing Minnesota. That the guys responded. I thought Keith was great. With Lively going down, stepped in and played a lot of minutes. But I thought the bench was great. 52 points from the bench tonight. So normally it's the starters who kind of carry the load, but tonight you saw the bench was big.
What has Markieff been doing to earn time, or is it just nature of you guys being shorthanded?
No, I think it's he's a pro. And we've been playing him some minutes here of late. Just being able to stretch the defense also gives us some physicality, some toughness. Knows how to play. You saw that with the double teams, being able to shoot the midi, and then also being able to extend the 3 points, being able to shoot the three. And then he showed that he can pass. A nice pass to D. Jones there for a lob. So. There's a lot of trust with Smooth. He's always been prepared. He's always ready, and that's what you can ask for when you're that 12, 13, 14 man on the team. But on this team, anybody is going to play, and everybody's going to play. You just have to be ready. And I think he's a perfect example for those young players in our locker room how to be a pro.
Do you just lose words, Jason, when you're trying to describe what Luke is able to do night in and night out?
Yeah, when you talk about someone who passed Dirk for the most 35-point games, Dirk played for 100 years, and Luke has played for 6. That's how good he is. And then you talk about passing Will for the most 40-point triple-doubles. I mean, that's just not special. I've said this day one, and will continue, is that we can't take him for granted. He is special. And again, what he did tonight, you can say shorthanded. He goes out there and puts his teammates in a position to be successful. I don't know if you guys have seen, but even when they made the run, he brought the team together. You can see the maturity. There's no panic with this young man. So it's pretty special to watch on the nightly or the daily. We're lucky as coaches and teammates to be able to watch him play.
The injuries to Lively, is it anything serious you have concern about?
Yeah, it's just a sprained ankle. X-rays were negative, so just a sprained ankle.
Lucas scoring 30 points in the first half. It seemed like you guys had a lot of success against drop coverage with DeAndre Ayton on the floor. What makes Lucas so challenging for a defense to contain in drop coverage?
Yeah, when you look at the drop coverage, his ability, if you set a screen and hold the screen, the ability to shoot the three, the ability to get to the basket, and then being able to be a threat to pass. So it's tough. I don't know. For a young man to get double teamed as much as he has, and is averaging over 30 points a night, 8 assists, 8 rebounds, it's just amazing what he's capable of doing against not just the drop, but any defense. And I think just the patience he's having with the double team, because he knows it's coming, but the trust that he has with his teammates. But the question you asked about the drop, I think that's probably one of his favorite defenses.
A nice comeback game for Tim. What did you see from him tonight?
Yeah, we talked about it earlier about being the sixth man of the year. I think it was a great bounce back game. The last one, he had great looks in that game at home against Minnesota.
Jason, you double-teamed Luka for most of that second half, and you had not only Markieff but Derek, 5 guys in double figures with this little of a roster. How big was that?
Yeah, it's huge. It starts with Luka, the trust, the energy he has when he passes the ball. He trusts once he lets go of it that he's done his part in the advantage basketball. We've seen a lot here early in the season, and guys have really studied and have become very comfortable and understand what they have to do. And you can see that with the ball movement and being able not just to settle for threes, but to attack. You see X is attacking, getting to the rim. But the other side of that, we're getting wide open threes. It's just something I still go
road record in the NBA. What is it about this team when you play on the road?
Maybe because we feel like we've been on the road the whole season.
True. So
you're going to play most of your games on the road. You're going to have to try to figure out how to win them. I think it's a group. It's a great question. I think we're comfortable on the road. I think we started outside the country, so we have to figure out how to win. But I think it's just guys are comfortable on the road. This is a close-knit group, so it's pretty cool.
I know you talked about the bench scoring 52 points. Can you talk about them performing on the other side of the ball?
Yeah, the defense, you know, you look at understanding we got to get stops, and I thought we did a good job there. In that second quarter, our pace would start to run and get looks, but our defense being able to limit, you know, Portland's a tough team because if they do miss, they tend to come up with the offensive rebound. So I thought the guys did a great job of boxing out and finding a way to come up with rebounds and then getting out and run. But our defense right now won't get a lot of recognition because, you know, we don't stop anybody or hold anybody under 100, but our defense puts us in a position to get out and run and find a way to score.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you. Thank you.